Hi there, Doug Stimmel with IT Creations with the 1U Dell PowerEdge R660xs Server. That little XS suffix does say something about this server when compared to the R660. We're going to get to the bottom of that. The R660xs is not the beast that the R660 is, which offers support for GPUs with a longer chassis length, plus an option for up to 16 EDSFF NVMe drives. Nope. Just like Goldilocks porridge, the R660xs is sized just right for a number of very specific applications. In that regard, Dell recognizes that not every business needs the highest performance potential and might want to save a little money too. Like our videos? Hit that subscribe button. Let's get to it. Just right. And that's the goal of the Dell PowerEdge R660xs, which is designed for lower power consumption and can use fifth or fourth generation gold or silver Intel Xeon Scalable processors to do just that. You can still load in some NVMe drives in the PowerEdge R660xs, but only 10 at 2.5 inch. No EDSFF NVMe drives are supported and no GPUs. It still offers dual CPUs and is designed to support the most popular workloads. Popular in this context almost makes it seem like the cool kid in high school. Not necessarily the football or basketball star, but a great all-around performer that likes to socialize for a multitude of tasks, like scale-out database, high-performance computing, virtualization, and use in public-private cloud. Just right. The front of the system can be outfitted with Dell's proprietary Beehive honeycomb bezel, either the optional security bezel or with integrated LCD screen. We have the standard bezel. There are slight differences between the 3.5 inch drive bay chassis and the 2.5 inch design, but both have a small control panel on the left with status LED indicators that include drives, temperature, electrical, memory, and PCIe slots. Next to that, a system health and system ID indicator. That, as an option, can be configured with an integrated Dell Remote Access Controller QuickSync 2 indicator, or iDRAC QuickSync for short. QuickSync is only available on certain configurations. When activated, administrators can use the OpenManage mobile app with a smartphone or tablet to manage the system, access inventory, troubleshoot the system, and address a host of other high-level management utilities. Are you interested in the Dell PowerEdge R660xs server? If you are, then for a limited time you can save up to $500 off on a system that's listed or one that you can configure that's valued at $5,000 or more. I mean, think about all the things you can do and the things you can think. Not that. Anyways, just click that link to learn more, and when you're ready to make a purchase, just mention this video, and then think about all the meetings you'll go to. When they realize how much money you save them on this just right-sized server. On the right-hand side, another small control panel with a power on button, a USB 2.0 port, and micro AB USB iDRAC direct port that allows you to connect a laptop or tablet. Where the chassis types somewhat diverge is the placement of the VGA port. It's right next to the left of the right-hand control panel on the 2.5 inch bay chassis with 8 or 10 bays, but above the fourth drive bay on the 3.5 inch drive bay chassis. It could be above the third drive bay, I suppose. It really depends on whether they start at 0 or 1. Storage is flexible on this platform too, with options for 0 drive bays, 4 3.5 inch bays with SAS, SATA, HDDs, or SSDs, 8 2.5 inch drive bays outfitted with SAS, SATA, or NVMe drives, or 10 2.5 inch bays, again, that can be outfitted with SAS, SATA, NVMe drives. That last configuration will provide up to 153.6 terabytes of storage. We have the 10 bay version and NVMe backplane with two 960 gigabyte DC U.2 NVMe Gen 4 read intensive drives up front. You can install all NVMe, all SAS, all SATA, or go with combinations with 2 to 4 universal media bays supporting SAS, SATA, or NVMe. Getting around to the back of the chassis, optionally, you can install 2 more 2.5 inch SAS, SATA, or NVMe drive bays for an additional 15.2 terabytes of storage. That said, 30 terabyte drives are now being offered on other Dell platforms, so probably fair to say those capacity figures are already outdated. Contrary to the split PSU configuration on the R660, the R660xs has both PSUs aligned on the right of the chassis, where we have dual redundant 800 watt PSUs. This is because the R660 has a T-shaped motherboard to accommodate better cooling for those GPUs, but also maybe for the direct liquid cooling option. The R660xs has a more traditional motherboard. There is also an additional lower wattage 600 watt platinum rated PSU that has been added to the R660xs list. This provides an option for even lower power consumption. However, that is dependent on the configuration. Other than that, you still have the option to install an 1800 watt titanium PSU and various other wattages in between. Immediately adjacent to the PSUs is the system ID button with integrated LED, VGA port, OCP 3.0 compatible mezzanine card slot with those options again for network connection port and speeds. Besides that, the USB 3.0 port with a 2.0 port on top. Then you have the dedicated RJ45 management port to access iDRAC and then dual gigabit Ethernet ports, which can also be configured to access iDRAC. Wedged in between the PCI cover panels, above is a removable panel where a boot-optimized storage subsystem card can be installed, specifically a BOSS N1 modular card. The BOSS N1 can be outfitted with one or two NVMe M.2 drives with capacities of either 480 gigabytes or 960 gigabytes for OS or hypervisor support. To manage the system, Dell does have a few options. iDRAC 9.0, accessible from the optional QuickSync OpenManage Bluetooth connection on the front panel. Our iDRAC 9 video is right there. iDRAC Direct from the right-hand side control panel, laptop not included, and the dedicated iDRAC port on the back of the system for remote management of the system using a standard browser interface. Also iDRAC RESTful API with Redfish, that would be for managing just this single server. OpenManage, on the other hand, will provide management for many servers by leveraging the information provided by iDRAC in each server. OpenManage will also provide integration with VMware vCenter, Microsoft System Center, Windows Admin Center, and a few others. Our system has dual Intel Xeon Silver 4410Y processors with 12 physical cores and 24 virtual threads each, for a total of 24 physical cores. With 8 memory module slots per processor, this system has half the memory module slots compared to the R660, which supports 32 memory module slots and no caps on CPU cores like on this system. Only 32 physical cores per 4th gen CPU or 28 cores per 5th gen CPU are supported. The standard R660 can support the full 64 physical core count offered by 5th generation Intel Xeon Scalable CPUs, or 60 on the 4th gen. We've installed 4 64GB dual-rank DDR5 4800 megatrans per second RDIMM memory modules for up to 128GB of memory. I think our clients for this system may be planning on an upgrade at some point, because with all 16 slots outfitted with 64GB modules, that would provide the 1TB maximum capacity on this system. Whether they do that or not is unknowable. Memory speed will also tank at 4,000 megatrans per second, as the Silver CPUs do not support higher memory speeds. That said, another reason for this platform is that Dell's research indicated the vast majority of their customers don't install more than 1TB of memory on their servers. Only 16 memory module slots is also another way of controlling cost. There are a few memory pathways when you compare it to the R660 with 32 slots and a maximum capacity of 8TB. Notice this system also has gold fans instead of just the standard fans. Also, no DLC or direct liquid cooling is offered on this system, which is not to say you couldn't probably install some from the parts listed for the R660 if you wanted to, but motherboards are different and you might have a hard time with the modified PCI slots for DLC. Anyways, no hardware perk controller on this system either, and no BOSS module. Depending on how many CPUs are installed, you can get either two PCI slots, including one x16 PCI 4.0 slot and one x8 PCI 5.0 slot, with dual processors, up to three PCI 4.0 slots, one x16 and two x8 slots, or you can get two PCI 5.0 slots with one x16 and one x8. As GPUs are not supported on this chassis like on the R660 server without the XS, you have a choice of HD controllers, or as Dell refers to them, PowerEdge RAID controllers, PERCs, or you can install additional network interface controllers, or NICs. Again, there are many options for the Dell PowerEdge R660xs server, from storage to networking to CPUs, memory, and many others. That said, Dell does make a definite effort to somewhat minimize configuration options for this particular platform to help reduce cost and power consumption. I do hope you enjoyed this short overview. If you're interested in purchasing one of these or learning more, visit IT Creations using one of the links in the description below or by clicking that link right there. Until next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations. Thanks for watching.